I'm going to show how I update records in an Access database using a Tableadapter and dbdirect methods. First, click on the install file and make sure the data storage components are installed for your Visual Studio version. On my desktop, I have the database I'll be using. It has a table of movies with four columns: ID, title, release year, and image path. I start by reading the movies from the database and displaying them in this list view. First, connect to the database by going to Data Sources and adding a new data source. Select Database Source Type. Select the Dataset Model. Choose New Connection, then select the database. Test the connection. Select OK. Select Next. I'm selecting No to copying the database locally, and Yes to creating the connection stream. For the database objects, I'll include both tables, but I'll only work with the movies table. Click Finish. Now I'll build the project so the table adapters are created in the toolbox. Make sure the project name is different than the project file names because that may cause the build to fail. When the build completes, in the toolbox on the components, you'll see the data set and table adapters for each table. Drag the data set and movie table adapter onto the form. In the code, I'll create a sub to read the movies and show them in the list view. I'll use a data row variable to loop through the data set, and a counter to track the number of movies read. Now use the table adapter's fill method to pull movies into the data set. Then I'll clear the list view items and the image list. Use a for statement to loop through each row in the data set. Add the title column of the row to the list view. Add release year to the list view. Add the image to the image list. Set the list view item image index. Set the tag to the ID. And increment the counter. Now read movies when the form loads, run it, and you can see the two movies from the database. Next is inserting a movie. Store text box input to variables, then use a table adapter's insert method to pass the input values. After, display a success message and read the movies. Also going to call a sub to clear all the controls. Here's the clear input sub. Now I need to call an insert from the save click event. Run it, and I'll add a movie. Next is updating a movie. First, I need to populate the text boxes with the original values when a movie is selected. Go to list view, select the index changed event. If selected items count is greater than 0, I'll create a variable to hold the first selected index, an ID variable to hold the movie ID of the selected index, and a data row to get the movie from the dataset. Set the first selected index. Get the selected movie ID stored in the item tag. Then use the dataset find by ID method to get the movie. Set text box values to the original row values. Also enable the delete button for later. If nothing is selected, I'm calling clear input. Run it. When I select different movies, it's populating the text boxes. Now I'll continue with update movie. It will be similar to what I've done already. I'm going to get the selected movie again. Get the new values entered in the text box. Use the table adapter's update method, passing the new and original values. It's not requesting original image path because the field type is long text. You can add your own update method that doesn't require original values if needed. Add message display, read, and clear input again. Now in the save button code, I need to call update if a record is selected. Run it. And I'll change Parasite to a new movie. The last option is delete, which uses the delete method. Call it from the delete click event. Run it, and I'll delete a few movies. And that's it.